The 2017 federal tax code contained a provision to spur growth in economically depressed areas. Why not create special opportunity zones to lure investors there by giving them tax breaks? On paper, the idea made sense, but the reality turned out to be different. Some investors exploited the provision to build instead high-end luxury projects. For exposing the practice, the award for financial reporting goes to Noah Buhayer, Caleb Melby, and David Kocieniewski, as well as Lauren Leatherby of Bloomberg News.
Hi, I'm Noah Buhayer from Bloomberg News. I want to thank the organizers of the George Polk Awards on behalf of myself and my colleagues Caleb Melby and David Kocieniewski, as well as our editors Robert Friedman and David Shear. Back in 2018, we all got interested in a little notice piece of President Trump's tax overhaul called Opportunity Zones. The idea was to get people to invest in some of the poorest parts of America, but we quickly found out that there were lots of opportunities for abuse. For starters, many of the zones were in parts of America that were doing just fine. And as we dug a little deeper, we found out that investors were proposing projects that just really didn't seem like they'd help the poor. And then on top of it all, some of the president's friends and family seemed like they were rushing to cash in. There were many points during this reporting that were difficult, required lots of digging and shoe leather reporting, but there were also moments that were just bizarre and made us laugh. For instance, we found a manufacturer in Oregon that had raised millions of dollars to produce $300 sex toys in an opportunity zone. Anyway, it's been an adventure and we're just thrilled for this honor and wish we could be there in person to celebrate with the other amazing reporters who also won awards. We hope everyone stays safe and healthy through this crisis, and thank you again.